Hey guys again. So in talking about Thanksgiving, I realize there's a couple of more things that I want to say about it. Most of it kind of negative. So maybe I thought to make a separate video in which I talk about some of the problems I have with this holiday, or maybe just the history of the holiday. Don't really want to go into talking about like how we celebrate this holiday, because probably that's not something that I want to really tackle or address in this channel. Oh, sorry. Got a text. Anyway, I mean, history-wise, it's pretty obvious, like the problems that exist with this holiday. It's not an entirely accurate celebration of history. It is a his celebration of a distorted history. If we're celebrating it to be like, oh, we're so thankful that Native Americans were friendly, and we're so thankful that we're celebrating this massive achievement of Europeans coming to this country and starting this continent and starting this country and all that. That's a very problematic view of Thanksgiving, right? Because it's not how it was. This country would not exist the way it is if it wasn't for a massive genocide and slavery of the natives that used to live here, and now their population in this country is like what, 1% of the entire population. So the natives have become decimated, and they a lot of them still continue to live under very much under the pressures of institutional discrimination and prejudice and things of that nature. And there's the legacy of slavery and oppression and genocide continues on to this day. So historically speaking, this holiday is not rosy dozy, so that's kind of out there already. A lot of us are definitely starting to be much more conscious about it, which I think is great. I think any college course that you take on American history will eventually also like there's a lot of discussion here that's happening in college campuses, and I think even in some high schools now, which I think is a great move forward from what it used to be. And maybe some things need to change with the middle school or elementary school educations, but I think we're slowly moving towards becoming more conscious of the historical problems of things that we don't want to admit is true, historically true, or perhaps strictly accurate about this holiday. There's still a lot of controversies within the details about this, and that's I think that's what makes to me. I'm a big fan of learning about history. I've always My favorite subject in school was history, and I think that kind of controversy is what always draws me to it. Some people, that's what makes them not interested, because there's no clear-cut answer in this subject. In math, you always know what the right answer is, and that might be also true for science. You're always discovering like equate solutions to the equation and things. In history, there's really no clear-cut answer, and there's also always a lot of controversy and discussion surrounding some things. So I always really love that. But that's the historical piece of it. I also want to talk about like my problems with my own experiences with Thanksgiving, because it was very religious experience in my family. My dad was a pastor, and the way we always celebrated this Thanksgiving in America was through church settings, and I don't really have a big problem with people, church members, or this extended family in a way. They're not biological family, but they're your church family, coming together and celebrating this time, just having a feast, enjoying company together, and that it's a fellowship time. That is, I think, is great. It's a very social event. But what really bothers me is this, th that's when the concept of Thanksgiving has a religious connotation to it. It is problematic because of the way we celebrate it, at least the way we celebrated it. I no longer really celebrated religiously with my family. Thanksgiving, I'm usually not in the same state as my family. I'm in New York. My parents are currently in Tennessee. My cousins and my aunt are in California, and rest of my biological family members are in Korea. So I'm the only person here of my family that's in New York. So I'm not going to be able to celebrate it with my family. And I, you know, that's not a big issue to me. But if we did celebrate it, we would celebrate it religiously. And my biggest issue with that is this concept of giving thanks to the Lord. Or, you know, there's always this thing that's like, oh, the best Bible verses of Thanksgiving, you know, giving thanks, always being thankful. And what the problem I have with the biblical concept of Thanksgiving is there's this big, we look down on, or at least the Christianity that I grew up with, it looks so much down on, you know, having complaints or expressing negative feelings or not being thankful about some things, like always be joyful, always be thankful, which I think is a concept I grew up with as being like that, like that thing I should always be striving to do, always being thankful about something. But seriously, like, think about that for a minute. In life, there's going to be things that just aren't that great. There's shitty things in life. Shitty things happen. There's awful things. And just because we have this day of this holiday where we're supposed to be thankful about everything doesn't mean everything is thankful. You know, some people have to work on this holiday. On this holiday, you know, some people die. Some people get ill. Bad things happen. And this Christian notion of, like, and recently, I just uploaded some videos in which I reacted to some chapters of Numbers, you know, the book of Numbers. And God goes really just, God of the Bible, God of Israel, goes just really angry when Israelites start complaining about, oh, we only have manna to eat. You know, we wish we had more meat. Oh, we had meat. We wish we had fruits and things, other things to eat other than this manna that God is providing us. We would rather go back to Egypt and be slaves in Egypt again than be doing this. Huge complaint, you know. And of course, God gets angry because God is providing them this miracle of providing them manna. But instead of the Israelites being all thankful, they're complaining that they're not getting enough. And Moses at one point goes, it's like, oh my gosh, what is enough for these people? You're doing all these things. You're going to, you know, provide them quail now. And they're still going to complain. What is enough for these people to satiate their desires? And Moses gets frustrated. God gets angry. So the whole theme of this story that is taught in Christianity is that, you know, God is providing you. Why are you complaining? Why are you being so negative and all that? You know, why are you being me all the time? Which is weird because now how we celebrate Thanksgiving now is very in this country at least, very capitalist focused, very consumerist oriented. So in light of this, you know, which I get the message behind that, you know, it's not a great thing to be always just be complaining and naggy and quite honestly annoying all the time, you know, but trying to preach to people that, like, oh, you should always be thankful no matter what and contribute all the good things about your life and about the world to God, and then just to swallow and to realize that all the bad things are there to build your character, this kind of message, I think, is really problematic. I think it's a message that gets really just hammered on, like, just ridiculously during this time, especially in churches. Cathedrals and such, this message, Christianity at least, I'm not really sure about other religions, but the religion that I'm familiar with, this is the message that just gets just so drilled in this time of the year. I think in some ways, that does a lot of disservice to people who are actually, you know, have a legitimate reason to not be thankful. You know, there are things to be complaining about, and I think it's okay to, you know, be ungrateful. Is that has a negative connotation, but I don't mean any negative connotation when I use that word. It's okay to feel ungrateful, to be ungrateful, and to even express that you're ungrateful about certain things. To me, this holiday is pretty much a good excuse to me, at least, to kind of enjoy each other's company and to share each other's company and to have a good celebration time for a reason. And it might not work out so well. I know there's a big focus on this family gathering. And on the one hand, that's great. On the other hand, that's the source of the problem, because these are all these people you're related to by blood that you haven't seen for a long time, for a whole year. Now you come to meet them, and they, you know, there's going to be a lot of family drama that might happen. You know, anything that you talk about could lead to a big fight, a family fight, or a big family feud. You know, talk about Obamacare in this family gathering. Whew, who knows what's going to happen there? So it's not necessarily a great thing. And, you know, and when I was in my internship, you know, I was talking with a student that is a client of mine, you know, how she feels about Thanksgiving. And that's kind of the thing. It's like, on the one hand, it's good to meet with their family members, but on the other hand, oh shit, I'm meeting with these family members that I haven't met this whole, you know, in the past 11 months or whatever. I don't want to meet them, but it's kind of, and it's going to be very big source of trouble, especially when you're so different from the other family members. You know, there are stories of people who are gay, but all the other family members don't come out. I mean, don't know, and they come out, and you know, it usually they end up coming out on this holiday or for some because of whatever, and that becomes a huge thing. And there's so many ways this family gathering can go wrong, but this is the holiday where that is celebrated and that's focused, and so I think there's a lot of things that we overlook or do disservice to when we say this is a time to be thankful. And my response to that is not necessarily. It's not necessarily time to be thankful, because there's a lot of things that we life can be very shitty, and I think it's alright to acknowledge that it is shitty sometimes. But that's kind of my thoughts on the whole thing. I don't know. Anyway, so cheers. Hope you guys have a great Thanksgiving family gathering, if you're family gathering, and I hope you guys don't get into this humongous drama, but if you do, I hope you come out of that okay. But yeah, thanks.